as a player, for me, it was very terrible feeling that I was not playing, and that, of course, people think that, oh, he's just sitting there for his money, but it was not like that. If I could do it like over, I would have done it very differently. And I think the people of Chelsea who was taking these decisions would also like maybe take a different decision. Fiali bought me, and when I was there, a week after, he got sacked. Yeah. If a manager is telling you that, okay, you're gonna get a fair chance right now, and in a short moment it already changed, and you don't get a chance at all, I was feeling hurt as a player. I was already like 30, 31, and it was my last contract. Well, in my head, it was my last contract. Yeah. So they had to cut the cost. At a certain point, and we had a very like big selection of players, so a few players had to go.
Was there a particular falling out with Ranieri?
When the manager is telling you something like, okay, now you're gonna get a fair chance, and two weeks later, that whole idea changed. So I mean, I was an experienced player.
Yeah.
I had been through a lot already. If it was from him or the club, I don't know. But it was very difficult to get a fair chance at that time, and I didn't play, unluckily for me, that much.
So you got the impression that once Ranieri came in, after a little bit of time, whether it was Ranieri or the club, they wanted you to leave.
In this way, you're looking for a solution for the club, you're looking for a solution for the player. And we talked about those things. Of course, I wanted to go on loan, but for instance, a club could not pay my whole salary. Mm. They could maybe pay for 70%, but Chelsea said no. If you want to take him, it's going to be 100% or nothing.
Were you tempted at all to go just to be able to play football?
Of course, for as a player, for me, is it's terrible not to play. I mean, of course, you want to play every week, you want to play every game.
So is it not true that you would, in your final season, or is it true that in your final season you commuted to training from here, from Holland?
No, of course not.
No, that's complete.
I don't understand how people come to these like ridiculous stories or lies or whatever. I've always been on the training at Chelsea. Every training that I was been, I've always been on time. I've never skipped a training, or I was never sick. I had never problems or in any kind of way with the club or like in private matters or whatever. So I don't understand how people come to these kind of things. Mentally, for a player, it's going to be tough because you're working every hard. You're training. You're not playing. To keep the motivation, it's very difficult.
When you walked away from Chelsea and then when it didn't quite work at Ajax afterwards, you know, to become a player, did you at that point think you would be a trainer coach at one point, or were you just at that point just needed a break?
I didn't really think that I wanted to be a trainer coach, because I've watched all the coaches in all these years, and the stress and the way they were dead busy with the team. And you know, it seemed like a very heavy job.
I believe you're only 44. Is that correct?
I'm 44 right now.
Well, that's very young.
You think?
Well, I'm 43, so I'm bound to say that.
No. I'm feeling young.
But I mean, especially for a trainer coach, for a manager, that's very young. What sort of manager? You know, how would you like to play football?
I've been playing in teams that have been playing dominant attacking football. So. Eventually, that's what's keeping me. That's what is catching me. Like, yeah, I want to play that also. But of course, you have to look at what kind of players you have, and to look what kind of team you can put on the pitch, and what kind of style or what kind of like system you want to play.
When you see Van Gaal's Manchester United now, you play. Is he still trying to play the same way as when you played for him, or
he doesn't have the players now to play that soccer? He wants that,
right? Okay.
But he's this season there. I mean, it's his first season. I know it's gonna take him some time. He has the same authority like Ferguson had.
You're still quite big friends with Patrick Kleiber, is that correct?
Yeah. I mean, maybe not him necessarily, but do you have maybe, you know, some friends in football who may give you a chance?
Of course, you've tried at the people who you know in football, and but until now, there hasn't been a break yet for me. So I'm still trying.
I was looking through your playing career. What was? Can you pick out one highlight?
Winning the Champions League is, of course, for me as a player has been one of the biggest.
You're so young then as well.
Yeah, right? I was 20. I was 24. The rest of the team was also young. Only Rijkaard has had that big success. We had a fantastic team, and from that moment on, the years were fantastic. And the highlight is winning the Champions League in '95 was tremendous. Was a fantastic feeling.
Got the call to that Bolton were interested, and you know, I'd not played a lot of football in a year and a half. I was probably, I'm guessing, 8, 9, 10 kilos overweight.